Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the previous lectures, we saw how to multiply and divide fractions. We also saw that adding and subtracting fractions is easy, as long as they have the same denominators. In that case, it's very much like adding and subtracting integers. For example, on the number line, adding the fractions 2/3 minus 6/3 minus 2/3 plus 4/3 looks a lot like adding the integers 2 minus 6 minus 2 plus 4. Except that each division represents 1/3 unit instead of 1 whole unit. This is why we simply add the numerators of each fraction, since the numerators specify the number of divisions in each fraction. Since the size of the division is not changed, the denominators are not affected. But how can we add or subtract fractions whose denominators are not the same? For example, let's say that we want to add the fraction 1/3 and 1/2. We can use the number line to visualize this. Since the fraction 1/3 has a denominator of 3, each unit length on the number line is divided into 3 equal divisions. And the fraction 1/3 is represented by one of these divisions. On the other hand, the fraction 1/2 has a denominator of 2. So each unit length on the number line is divided into 2 equal divisions. And the fraction 1/2 is represented by one of these divisions. Unfortunately, when we add these two fractions, the sum won't fit into either set of divisions. This is true whether we use 3 divisions per unit or 2 divisions per unit. Since each fraction is expressed using different size divisions, it's like trying to add apples and watermelons. The solution is to create new divisions which will work for both fractions. We need to divide the unit length in such a way that each fraction will fit perfectly into these new divisions. If we do this, then both fractions can be represented by some number of these new divisions. Since both fractions will then use the same size divisions, they will have the same denominator. In other words, they will have a common denominator. We can then simply add their numerators. For instance, in this example, we can split each division on the top number line in half. Each unit length on the top line will then be divided into 6 equal pieces, and the fraction 1/3 will be represented by 2 of these divisions, or 2/6. Now if we split each unit on the bottom number line into thirds, each unit on the bottom line will also be divided into 6 equal pieces. The fraction 1/2 will be represented by 3 of these divisions, or 3/6. Both fractions now represent some number of the same size divisions. So now we can add their numerators. And we see that these two fractions add up to 5/6. So when adding or subtracting fractions with different denominators, we must find a single denominator which will work for all of the fractions. In other words, we must find a common denominator. So, how do we find this common denominator? Finding a common denominator is easy. We simply multiply each fraction's denominator by the denominator of the other fraction. This way, both fractions end up with a denominator equal to the product of the two denominators. But when we change a fraction's denominator, we must also change its numerator so that the fraction still represents the same quantity as it did before. Let's see how this works on the number line. In the previous example, we started with the fraction 1/3. We then split each division on the number line into two pieces. There were then twice as many divisions per unit length, so we had to multiply the denominator by 2. The fraction 1/3 then represented twice as many of these new smaller divisions, so we also had to multiply the numerator by 2. So the new equivalent fraction was created by multiplying both the numerator and the denominator by 2. Likewise, we took the fraction 1/2 and split each division on the number line into 3 pieces. There were then 3 times as many divisions per unit length, so we had to multiply the denominator by 3. The fraction 1/2 then represented 3 times as many of these new divisions, so we also had to multiply the numerator by 3. So this new equivalent fraction was created by multiplying both the numerator and the denominator by 3. Multiplying the numerator and denominator of a fraction by the same number doesn't change its value, since it is the same as multiplying the entire fraction by 1. And it is this trick which will allow us to change any fraction into an equivalent fraction with a different denominator. When adding or subtracting two fractions, the simplest way to create a common denominator is by multiplying the numerator and denominator of each fraction by the other fraction's denominator. In our example, both the numerator and the denominator of the fraction 1/3 were multiplied by 2, which was the denominator of the 1/2. And the numerator and denominator of the 1/2 were both multiplied by 3, the denominator of the 1/3. So we multiplied the top and bottom of each fraction by the other fraction's denominator. This gave us 2/6 plus 3/6, and 2/6 plus 3/6 is 5/6. So we found that 1/3 plus 1/2 is equal to 5/6. Let's try another example, adding the fractions 2/5 and 3/7. To create the common denominator, we multiply the numerator and denominator of the fraction 2/5 by the denominator of 3/7. And we multiply the numerator and denominator of 3/7 by the denominator of 2/5. This gives us 14/35 plus 15/35. And 14/35 plus 15/35 is 29/35. So 2/5 plus 3/7 is 29/35. One last example, subtracting the fraction 3/2 minus 2/3. Once again, to create a common denominator, we multiply the top and bottom of the fraction 3/2 by the denominator of 2/3. And we multiply the top and bottom of the fraction 2/3 by the denominator of 3/2. This gives us 9/6 minus 4/6, which is equal to 5/6. So 3/2 minus 2/3 is 5/6. By finding a common denominator, we can add or subtract fractions with different denominators. However, sometimes when we multiply the denominators of fractions together to find a common denominator, we create an unnecessarily large common denominator. We will see in the next lecture how to find the smallest possible common denominator, otherwise known as the least common denominator.